The first problem was for Arjuna how to kill the kinsman, family man. Now, when he was chastised by Krishna as a friend, why you are so weak? Don't be weak. This is sentiment, this kind of compassion is sentiment. Uttishtha, get up and fight. But we can, if I do not want to do something, I can offer so many pleas. So, next, he is presenting Guru, or like Krishna, you are talking about my kinsman, I accept that it is my weakness. But how do you advise me to kill my Guru? Dronacharya is my Guru, and Bhishma Devi is also my Guru. Do you want me to kill my Guru? Guru nihi hatya. And not only ordinary Guru. It is not that they are ordinary men. Mahanubhava, Bhishma, is a great devotee. And similarly, Dronacharya also is a great personality. Mahanubhava. So, Patam Bhishma Maham Sankhi Dronancha Madhusudana. They are two great personalities. They are not only my gurus, but they are great personalities. And Krishna is addressed Madhusudana. Madhusudana means Madhu was Krishna's enemy, a demon. So he came. So you are Madhusudana, you are killer of your enemies. Can you give me any evidence that you have killed your Guru? So why you are asking me? This is the purpose. Isubhi Pratijasvami Pujaraha Barisudana. Again, Arisudana. Ari means enemy. Madhusudana particularly the killer of the Madhu, Dima. And next is Arisudana. Ari means enemy. So, Krishna has killed so many demons, Ari, who came to fight with him as enemy. Therefore his name is Arisudana. So Krishna has got enemies also. What to speak of ourselves? This material world is so mad that you must have some enemies. Matsarata. Matsarata means enviousness, jealous. This material world is like that. So, there are jealous enemies of God also. They are called demons. Ordinary jealousy or enemy, that is natural. But even to God, just yesterday night, evening, somebody came to see me. He was arguing that why Krishna should be accepted as God. That was his argument. So Krishna has enemies. Therefore Krishna, not only he, but everyone who is in the material world is enemy of Krishna. Everyone. Because they want to be competitor of Krishna. Krishna says that Mokta Aham, I am the Supreme Enjoyer. Sarvaloka Maheshwara. I am Supreme Prapada. And the Vedas also confirm. Hi Javasam. Idam Sarvam. Everything is the property of the Supreme Lord. Sarvam khalu idam brahma. These are basic injunctions. Jato vaimani bhutani jayanti. From whom everything has come. Karma adhyasya jataha. These are basic verses. But still, we, because we are enemy, no. Why Krishna says he is the proprietor? I am proprietor. Oh. Why Krishna says he got only? I have got another. Oh. Here is another one. So Krishna is enemy. Rishudana. And he has to kill them. Krishna has got two wills. Paritrana sadhana vinadhaya dushtita. Miscreants. They are miscreants, the demons who challenge Krishna, who want to compete with Krishna, who want to share with the property of Krishna. They are all enemies of Krishna. And they should be killed. So killing business is all right here for the enemies, not for the enemies. Then the next question is, all right, enemies you can kill, admit. But how you advise me to kill my guru? Guru Hatya. But if for Krishna's sake, if there is need, you have to kill your guru. That is the fear. For Krishna's sake, if Krishna wants, then you cannot. If Krishna wants that you should kill your guru, then you have to do it. That is Krishna's answer. Of course, Krishna will not ask you to kill guru, but because guru and Krishna is the same, Guru Krishna Kripa, we get Krishna consciousness through the mercy of Guru and Krishna. So, real Guru is never to be killed. As a so-called Guru has been killed. The so-called pseudo-Guru, false Guru, he should be killed. Just like Prahlad Maharaj. While Prahlad Maharaj, he was standing. Here is Nisimha Dev is killing his father. Father is Guru. Sarva Deva Maya Guru. Similarly, father is also Guru. At his official Guru. Materially he is Guru. So how Prahlad Maharaj allowed Nisimhadev to kill his guru, his father, everyone knows that Hiranyakashipu is father. Would you like to see that your father is being killed by some person and you stand, you will not protest? Is that your duty? No, that is not your duty. When your father is attacked, you must protest. At least if you are unable, you must fight. You first of all lay down your life. How is that? My father is being killed in my front. That is your duty. But Prahlad Maharaj did not protest. He could have requested his devotee, my dear sir, Prabhu, my Lord, you can excuse my father. He did it. But he knew that my father is not being killed. It is the body of the father. Later on, he begged for his father in a different way. First of all, when Nishimhadri was angry, was killing the body. He knew that the body is not my father. His soul is my father. So let the Lord satisfy himself by killing the body of my father, then I shall save. So Prahlad Maharaj, Nishimhadev offered Prahlad Maharaj, now you can take any kind of benediction you like. The Prahlad Maharaj replied, my Lord, we are materialists. I am born of a father, absolutely materialist. So, I am also, because I am born of a materialist father, I am also materialist. And you, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, you are offering to give me some benediction. I can take any kind of benediction from you, I know that. But what is the use of it? Why shall I ask you for any benediction? I have seen my father materially, you are so powerful that even the demigods, Indra, Chandra, Varuna, they were threatened by red eyes. And he gained over control over the universe. You are so powerful. And riches, wealth, power, reputation, everything complete. But you have finished it in 1 second. So why you are offering me such benediction? What shall I do with that? If I take that benediction from you and I become papa and do everything wrong against you, then you can finish it within a second. So kindly, do not offer me such benediction, such material offering. Better give me benediction to be engaged in the service of your servant. I want this. Let me be benedicted by you, that I may be engaged in the service of your servant, not directly. Your servant. Then after many prayers, after pacifying the Lord, he was very angry. Then when he was little pacified, he asked, my dear Lord, I can ask you one another benediction. That my father was very, very staunch enemy of you. That was the cause of his death. Now I ask you, kindly excuse him and give him liberty. This is Vaishnava Sangha. He did not ask anything for himself. And although he knew that his father was the greatest enemy, still he's asking his benediction. This poor fellow may be liberated. So, Lord Nishimhadev guaranteed, said, my dear Prahlad, not only your father, but your father's father, his father, up to 14 generations, all are liberated. Because you are born in this family. So, anyone who has become a Vaishnava, a devotee of the Lord, he is giving the greatest service to the family. Because in relationship with him, his father, mother, anyone, they will be liberated. Just like we have got experience. If a person dies in the fight immaturely, his family is taken care of by the God. Similarly, to become a devotee is the greatest qualification. He has got everything. Jatra yoga sara hari, jatra dhanadhara, part. When there is Krishna and when there is devotee, all victory, all glories are there. That is guaranteed. So Guru Nhatta, a devotee of Krishna, he need be, if he is called unqualified Guru. Unqualified Guru means who does not know how to guide the disciple. Guru's duty is to guide such kind of Guru. Can we at least reject that is Jiva Goswami. Kajatajama Janata. A guru who does not know what to do and what not to do, but I mistake, by mistake I have accepted somebody as guru, he can be rejected. By rejecting him, you can accept an actual bona fide guru. The guru is not give, but he can be rejected. That is injunction of this heart. So, Bhishma Dev or Dronacharya, certainly they were guru. But Krishna indirectly giving indication to Arjuna that although they are in the position of guru, he can reject them. Kaja kajama janata, they do not know. Actually, this Bhishma Dev, he materially considered his position. He knew everything from the beginning that the Pandavas, they were parentless, fatherless children, and he raised them from the very beginning. Not only that, he was so much affectionate to the Pandavas that he was thinking when they are sent to forest, banished, at that time, Bhishma Dev was crying that these five boys, they are so pure, so honest, and not only pure and honest, so powerful warriors, Arjuna and Bhim. And this Draupadi is practically, directly the goddess of fortune. And they have got their friend, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Krishna. And they are suffering. He cried. You are such affectionate, therefore, Arjuna is considering, how can I kill Bhishma? But duty is so strong, Krishna is advising, yes, he must be killed, because he has gone to the other side. He has forgotten his duty. He should have joined it. Therefore, he is no more in the position of Guru. You must kill him. He has wrongly joined the other party. Therefore, there is no harm to him. Similarly, Dronacharya. I know they are great personalities. They have got great affection. But only on material consideration they have gone there. What is that material consideration? Bhishma thought that I am maintained by the money of Duryodhana. Duryodhana is maintaining me. Now he is in danger. If I go to the other side, then I should be ungrateful. He has maintained me so long. And if I, in the time of danger, when there is fighting, if I go to the other side, that should be. He thought like this. He did not think that Duryodhana may be maintaining. But he has used the property of the Pandavas. But it is his greatness He knew that Arjuna will never be killed because Krishna is there. So, from material point of view, I must be grateful to Duryodhana. The same position was for Dronacharya. They are maintained. Therefore, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has said that Vishayir Anna Khaile Molin Hoy Mo. Such great personalities became darkened because they took money from them. Anna, if I am provided by somebody who is too much materialist, then that will affect me. I will become also materialist. I will also become materialist. So, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has warned that those who are visayi, those who are not devotees, do not accept anything from them. Because it will, as I say, make your mind unclean. So, therefore, Brahmana and Vaishnava, they do not accept directly money. They accept bhiksha. Bhiksha. Bhiksha you can use. Just like here it is said, bhiksham. Shriya bhoktum bhiksham apiha loki. When you ask somebody, still, bhiksha is also sometimes prohibited from a person who is too much materialist. But bhiksha is allowed for sannyasi, for brahman. So therefore Arjuna is speaking that instead of killing such great gurus, who are so great personality, Mahanubhava, so bhikkham, for a kshatriya, a brahmana, a sannyasi, can beg alms, but not a kshatriya, not a vaishya, that is not allowed. This, you are a kshatriya, Arjuna. So, he says, better I shall take the profession of a brahmana and beg from door to door instead of enjoy the kingdom by killing my guru. That was his proposal. So on the whole, Arjuna is illusion. Illusion in this sense that he is forgetting his duty. He is a kshatriya. His duty is to fight. Never mind the opposite party. He is even his son. A kshatriya will not hesitate to kill his son if he is inimical. Similarly, a son, if the father is inimical, he would not hesitate to kill his father. This is the stringent duty of the kshatriyas. No consideration. A kshatriya cannot consider like that. Therefore, Krishna said, Kleibam, don't be coward. Why you are becoming coward? These topics are going on. Later on, Krishna is giving real spiritual instruction. This is ordinary talks are going on between the friend and the friend. That's all. Thank you.